nice and long, as you can probably tell. Okay, so I guess there's gonna be tapping. I keep tapping on stuff. 250 matches, 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 matches. Traditions are still little known in the United States. It was largely to correct the situation and to enable their fellow Americans to share in the beauty and warmth of a Polish Christmas that the remarkable group of women known as the Polanyi Club undertook to prepare and to publish this work. It was a difficult task. How to choose that which is specifically Polish when so much of the enchantment of Eastern Europe is shared by many people? How to choose that which is typically Polish when the traditions of every province and often every village have a distinctiveness all their own? Difficult indeed, yet the author succeeded in capturing the essence of a Polish Christmas. In the pages which follow, one will find not merely a description of Polish Christmas traditions, but also a guide for a do-it-yourself Polish Christmas. Recipes for Christmas meals, the words and music for some of the more representative Polish carols, and even detailed directions for making typically Polish Christmas decorations. Follow this guide will bring happiness and enrichment to many at Christmastide. Hopefully it will encourage some to dig more deeply into the traditions of a remarkable people and to expand upon the first significant attempt to bring the story of a Polish Christmas to the attention of the American public. That's cute. That was written by Eugene Kusielewicz, the president of the Xoxo Foundation. Even though I'm Polish, I still can't pronounce that. So, this is obviously a very long book. I'm gonna just read a few passages and flip some pages, of course. It sounds so nice, this paper is so thick. Spring and summer, so the Christmas holidays become the adornment for winter living in Poland. Customs and traditions connected with these holidays and the preparation for them are brought about by conditions of environment, generations of living together, and the harmonious blending of ancient folklore and Christian beliefs. Come to the countryside of the Poland of long ago for the Christmas holidays. Here you will be warmly enfolded by the wings of faith expressed in the Pole's tender love for the Christ child. Here the irresistible spirit of Godi, love for all of God's creatures, will be brought to you with Poland's treasured traditions preserved through the ages. Interesting. I've never read this book, so it's fun and new for both of us. For all of us. Okay. Let's see. Let's keep going. a soft white blanket to get ready for Jesus' birth. Just as the mother prepares the crib of her newborn babe in snowy white linen. The impassable roads, brought little neighborly visiting, but, the cottage did not lack for guests as the dogs, cats, and sometimes the pet stork begged to be allowed near the warm hearth. Young geese, ducks, and chickens were often brought into the entry of the cottage for the night, not only because of the cold, but because the wolf or fox, in his quest for food, was edging nearer and nearer to the cottages. St. Nicholas Day brought a slight reprieve to gray, monotonous days, especially for the children who felt that the Christmas star would never come. St. Nicholas was revered because of his compassion and love for orphans, whom he often visited and comforted with little gifts. Little gifts. His name's day is celebrated more in some countries than is Christmas Day itself. This is true for Germany also, as told in the other video. The one selected to represent St. Nicholas was usually driven in a sleigh to the homes in a Polish village. He was dressed in a long white robe, wearing a tall headpiece, much like a bishop's mitre. A long white flowing beard, and his hand he held the shepherd's staff. The sound of snow bells and horses' hoofs could be heard on the cobblestone pavement, while eager young faces with their noses pressed to the window pane shouted, "He has come, he has come." It also says that in Polish, but I'm not going to try it. Because he always asked, "Have you been a good child?" There would be a hurried, frenzied exclamation of conscience while the chitsy was being called out. "Have I been greedy? Did I block the path once or twice so she fell? Was I lazy? How many lies did I tell?" While the owner of all of these dreadful childish sins shuddered and shivered, St. Nicholas entered, filling the room with not only his big presence, but with his smile, the twinkle in his eye, and his teasing, booming voice. He rebuked the mischievous, praised the obedient, and passed around heart-shaped pierniki, honey cookies, holy pictures, and big red apples, which he produced magically from under his cloak. He left with his children's shining eyes following him, the brightest on the littlest one hiding behind mother's apron. And it says piernik is a honey spice cake. Probably pronouncing that wrong, but it's spelled sometimes there's an I at the end and sometimes not. I don't know. Okay, so that is St. Nicholas Day. Let's keep going. Oh, okay. If you want to know how to make that, I'll read the recipes. Okay. So, Janina's piernik. 5 cups of flour. 5 cups of flour. 2 cups of sugar, 1 cup of honey, 1/2 cup of butter, 2 eggs, 1 teaspoon of baking soda, 1/4 teaspoon cream of tartar, 1/2 teaspoon clove, 1/4 teaspoon of cinnamon, and 1/4 teaspoon of nutmeg. It sounds pretty good. Let's read about With horseradish sauce and traditional poppy seed cake. I'll show it to you guys. It's pretty cool. So, pastirca is known as Shepherd's Mass, which happens at midnight. There's a little thing on that, but look. There's a section on Christmas Day. And then we have some recipes. If you were ever wondering, what do traditional Polish people eat on Christmas or during Christmas time? You're about to find out.
Okay.
So the first recipe is for hunter's stew, which contains 1 large white cabbage, 2 pounds of sauerkraut, 2 medium white onions finely chopped, 1 medium can of beef bouillon, 1 small can of tomato paste, 2 pounds of pork roast, 1 pound of Polish sausage coarsely chopped, 4 ounces of dried mushrooms, 1/2 pound of baked ham coarsely chopped, okay. 1 crushed bay leaf, just one, 12 coarsely ground peppercorns, that's specific, and roast or boar ham. Who just has like lots of leftover venison roast or boar ham? And like it has to be a leftover. Okay. Interesting. Okay, so to make rye bread, you need boiling water, molasses, shortening, salt, brown sugar, buttermilk, soda, I guess baking soda, rye flour, yeast cake, warm water, and white flour. So you need boiling water and white. No, sorry. You need boiling water and warm water. Interesting. Okay. So, holiday streusel. A paragraph about that. Why not? Okay. This day is also called the second Christmas in Poland. In some districts, this is the day reserved for sharing opłatek and kusia, sometimes made with buckwheat dumplings, with domestic fowl, birds, and animals. Gospodarz, this is embarrassing, guys, gave this food to the animals by hand, speaking to them. as he had an especially tender message. They shared with him his daily toil, and so should also share the oplitic. Horses were of special concern. They seemed to be ailing at this time. When it finally became known that their ailment was no more than their sudden complete inactivity over the holidays, St. Stephen's became the day on which they were harnessed to sleighs and taken out for exercise, a custom which later developed into the all-important Polish kulig. The sacraments of baptism and matrimony were not celebrated during Advent, so that many christenings and weddings were performed in church on this day of leisure, St. Stephen's. People attended Mass, taking with them various amounts of oats and peas, which could be more than a bushel or as little as a handful. The larger amounts they presented as gifts to the priest after Mass. They threw the smaller handfuls at either the priest as he departed for the sacristy, or at themselves in commemoration of St. Stephen, who was stoned to death. This practice has not been in existence for many years. Interesting. Fun fact, I was never baptized. So all of this information is probably common to a lot of people, but not to me. I'm like, what are these words? Like, what is a sacristy? I'm probably not even saying it right. I don't know. Okay. In contrast to the quiet of Christmas Day, St. Stephen's was spent in visiting friends and relatives, sometimes driving long distances. Christmas and Epiphany, the village was alive with unusual characters. That's what I like to hear. First came the Quiatstorts, star carriers, young lads carrying the illuminated star on a long pole. They carried it proudly, for it possessed magic. By one pull of the string, it began twirling rapidly. Lighted candle encased in its center made the colors of the many-hued iridescent paper come alive. People in cottages could see that the Quiatstorts, coming from a distance with a twinkling, shimmering star high up in the air. Some groups sang kolendi and recited verses in rhyme, most of which were cajoling, humorous, or complimentary to the Gotsports or Gospodni, host or hostess of the home. They would be amply rewarded with gifts of food and money. One of their verses might go something like this. May the dear Lord give you success and plenty of health, and in the pantry and barn much wealth. Dear Lord, give them everywhere, in the sack, in the field, here, there, in every corner a tiny dot, and near the stove three more to add to the lot. For these good wishes, we would like some cheese, pastry, ham, or kielbasa, please. May the good Lord bless you for it. I know kielbasa. The introduction of puppet theater in churches. That's interesting. there's a page here on Christmas Day dinner, which I'm going to read to you guys. It says, Christmas Day was formerly spent quietly visiting relatives and friends within the family group. Little or no cooking was done on this holy day in the past. Food was reheated or served cold.
Ew.
Okay, so for dinner, they usually would have ham, Polish sausage, bikos, which is hunter stew, rye bread, babka or plekianka, strusel, krupnik, coffee, tea, milk. Okay. So here are some suggested Christmas Eve suppers and Christmas Day dinner. Appetizers, we have pickled herring, chopped herring, and pickled mushrooms. A lot of pickling. For soups and additives, we have vegetable stock, easy borscht, fish soup, clear mushroom soup, ushka, meatless filling, egg drops and dumplings, ooh, pierogies, its own section, cheese and potato filling, cheese, mushrooms, sauerkraut and mushrooms, prunes, blueberries and cherries. That's one of our holiday traditions, actually, is pinching pierogies, and it's a lot of fun. We make them from scratch, and we put all different types of fillings in them, but it's a whole family affair. We sit down at a big table, we get the dough rolled out, we grab the filling material, we make the filling, and then whatever it is, we put into the dough, and then we fold the dough over, and we pinch the edges with a fork to give it that sort of like crisped look at the edges. And it takes forever, it takes so long. You put a lot of care into each pierogi, but it's a lot of fun. It's a cute holiday thing to do. We do it actually for Easter though, not for Christmas. For fish, they have boiled northern pike with horseradish sauce. Let me know if you guys like horseradish. I love it, but I think it's an acquired taste. Baked pike, trout or pike, creamed shrimp with rice, creamed fish, and jellied fish. Okay. For sauce, it says horseradish, and that's it. It's just horseradish. For salad, herring salad or sauerkraut apple and carrot salad. Vegetables, we have mushrooms and butter, creamed mushrooms, sauerkraut with dried peas, baked sauerkraut and mushrooms, red cabbage, beets and orange sauce, green beans and cauliflower. And the best part, desserts. We have cottage cheesecake, cream cheesecake, cheesecake with sour cream topping, Christmas kutia, Chopin's filled cookie, dried fruit and prune compote, nut pudding, poppy seed coffee cake, nalesniki, poppy seed coffee cake, oh I said that already, poppy seed filling, walnut tort, and Polish tea cakes. For liquor, they drink hot vodka with honey. What? Hot vodka with honey. I just can't imagine that would taste very good. I don't know. Maybe I'll have to try it just for research purposes, but that doesn't sound good to me. And then there's just like a whole bunch of dinner options. Wow, there's lots. More recipes. Okay. Let's flip some pages. Okay. circles from bright colored tissue paper for each flower, cut into middle to make fringe all around. And then it says, after circles are cut, string 12 circles together and flare out for a round flower. Use large flower on top and bottom of cage and small flower for the sides. That's confusing to me, but that's what it looks like, and those are the circles and the things you cut. But I think I'd have to read that like 6 more times to understand. Christmas story, but I don't have any of those, and I thought it'd be nicer to have a physical book than to just like look it up on my phone, but I think that would have been okay too. So anyways, I think this video has been long enough. I'm losing track of time, but I think I've been recording for a while, so I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Said, let me know if you have more Christmas requests. Would love to try to do some boxes and wrapping paper videos, or even ornaments.